What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy, Scooby-Doo, man. I know before y'all say anything, I know I hadn't made a video in a while. It's been treachery, man. It's been treachery. I'm going to come back right after Karen Hawthorne. I got to hear Karen Hawthorne because with that inspiration song, it gives me the words to say to as I won't offend anyone. But I want to reply to my boy SoCal, man. Great guy, SoCal, man. That guy there, man, he puts it down. I love his channel. Love SoCal's channel, man. Y'all go check out SoCal, man. That's the man. But I want to reply to a video that he uploaded and everything. So stay tuned. Right after Karen Hawthorne, your boy Scooby-Doo will be back and tell you where he been, what's been going on, and everything over at JB Hunt. So stay tuned. I'll be right back.
Ain't nobody stopping my shine. They try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus on my side. So bad I thought I would die, but ain't no power stronger than the one that came and laid down his life. And I got mountains to climb, but the enemy can't stop me, cause there's a calling on my life. So when I'm crying, don't last too long, cause he gon' step in and make it alright. Only do it, he said he would. Fight your battles.
Alright, welcome back to the Scooby-Doo Show. This your boy Scooby-Doo. Like Karen Hawthorne said, boy, won't he do it? Yes, he will, man. Won't he do it? I thank God for her, man. After my wife told me about that song, man, I've been listening to it ever since. But your boy got him another one I want y'all to listen to, man. I'm gonna play a little bit of that one at the end here. But man, I tell you, boy, when you're out there on that road by yourself and you riding and that song there comes on, it'll bring tears to your eyes, man. Tears to your eyes. But anyway, let me get this here going, man. I'm headed to the yard. I've got to go to Indigo this morning, and I've got to do my, what we talked about, the hazmat fingerprint and everything, the fingerprint background check again, which to me is very crazy. We'll talk about that. That's another topic we'll come back and talk some more on. But my boy SoCal, he posted a video about the $8.8 million that JB Hunt was giving to the giving back to the drivers. Well, they did do it. They did do it. I just said, when I saw the video, I said, ah, that's not true, that's a lie. And it's not a lie. It is true. I take that back. I'll be the first to admit when I'm wrong. That's one thing about your boy Scoob. When he wrong, he man enough to admit that he's wrong. And I do apologize to my subscribers and to SoCal subscribers that looked at that video. 4,400 views on it. 4.1 views. And I thank y'all for it. And like I said, I do apologize for that, but it is true. They did give a bonus to the drivers, $500 and everything. It went into the accounts and everything. Well, it went into the account, but it didn't go into everybody's account. Let me say that again. They put it out. They did give it out, but it did not go in everybody's account. Everybody did not get the bonus. I repeat, everybody did not get the bonus. The bonus went to, you had to be here a year. You had to be here a year. You had to have started January the 1st of 2022 and worked all the way up to January the 1st of 2023 in order to get the bonus. Like I said, I'm here at the terminal. I'm going to pick up these if the stickers, and then I'm trying to kill a little time. I got to be over there at 10 o'clock this morning at Indigo to do my fingerprinting and everything, background on my hazmat. But it is true. Once again, it is true. They did give $500 to the employees, to the drivers and stuff. I don't know how much they gave to office staff. I don't know how much they gave to upper management. I do not know. I don't know how much they gave to the shop people. I do not know. All I know is the driver's $500. So that is true. That is true. Thank J.B. Hunt for it, even though I didn't get it. I've been with J.B. Hunt since May the 1st and everything. I've been with him since May the 1st. So it don't count. You got to start January the 1st of 2022, and you have to have been here January the 1st of 2023. 1 year, anybody in between that, anybody after January the 1st, if you came on January the 10th or February the 10th, you do not get it and everything. You do not get it and everything. So that is the way that they doing it, which to me kind of suck, but hey, it is what it is, you know, it is what it is. So once again, to so-called SoCal viewers, to my viewers, it is true, and I do apologize on that. They did do it. They did give out a bonus to the drivers that been with the company for 1 year. So on that, after that note, everything's been kind of, it's how you say it is what it is. It is what it is. It's things that they do that I don't expect to be done at a mega carrier. Out of all my years of driving, I don't expect to see what I see at a mega carrier being done like it is here at J.B. Hunt. No communication. I mean that. I'm going to stick to that. It's no communication between the driver, the dispatcher, and the planners. No communication at all from my view. Now, from anybody else work here, that's their opinion. But from my opinion, is no communication at all. They don't tell you if your pre-plan been canceled. They don't tell you if your load been canceled. They send you to pick up a load at the rail. They won't send you the pickup number. And I don't know if it's just me they're doing that too. I don't know. I'm just speaking from Scooby-Doo. This is Scooby-Doo talking with the experience that I've experienced since I've been here. As far as equipment being fixed, I had an airbag, a drive shaft leaking on the truck, and it had right there at the pinion, and where the universal joint is, and they fixed it, but they didn't clean it up. So whoever fixed it, kudos to them. Thank you. Thank you for fixing it, but you're supposed to clean up behind yourself when you fix it. The equipment, these chassis, I see anywhere from 10 to 15 chassis sitting at the rail with a red tag on them. The reefer units, riding around trying to find a reefer unit, they out of service. They let Thermo King is the one that works on them. So this is just my experience, okay? And I'm not saying this. J.B. Hunt is a great company. They do what they said they gonna do. They will get you home. You set your time. One thing I can truthfully say about J.B. Hunt that I've enjoyed, if you got issues at home, they ain't gonna bother you. You just pick up the phone, set your driver ready time, which is on your app. You go in, you set it, say, hey, I'll be ready for this day and this time. And if something come up, go back in there, reset it again. And they won't bother you. They will not bother you. They don't hound you. If you need to be off for a week or a family emergency, one thing I can truthfully say, I give them an A+ on that. They do that. They stick to that. They don't, hey, man, need to know what's going on. When you going to come back to work? Man, you've been off for 2 weeks now. What's going on? When you going to make it? They will not do that at J.B. Hunt, because I guess they figure, hey, if he don't want to work, he don't want to make no money. But they will stop paying your insurance after 2 weeks. I think after 2 weeks, they ain't going to pay it no more. They're gonna just give you a zero check. Then when you come back to work, boom, they're going to hit you all for all of it. That week that you work plus those 2 weeks you didn't work, you're gonna pay for it. And I don't blame them for that. I think that's great what they do on that. But if you need to be off for 2-3 days, a week, 2 weeks, J.B. Hunt. Hey, J.B. Hunt is a great starter company, but you can grow to longevity with JB Hunt if you want to. There are some drivers that's got longevity with JB Hunt. Yes. Got longevity with JB Hunt. Been with him a long time, man. I talked to one of the guys here in Memphis. Been with him, what he said, 28, 26 years? Been with him 26 years and everything. Long time, man. Long time. So, you know, you can't build a longevity. The city drivers, them guys, they love it, man. They got a night shift. They got a day shift. Y'all share trucks, you know. So make sure you get, if you do the city, make sure you get with somebody that clean like you, you know, that's going to help take care of the equipment. Keep it clean. Keep the oil checked in it. Keep the water checked in it. Report any damages to the shop. That's what you need to be looking for. Make sure you get with somebody like that, because if you don't, it's a one-sided deal. You'll be doing all the work and they reaping the benefits from it and everything. But let's see, what else is it? Another thing I don't like is, one thing I don't like over here is they only let you get your truck washed once a month at the Blue Beacon, but they will not get to let you, they won't wash the truck at the Memphis terminal. Now let me say this here. Let me go on record to say this. When I say anything about equipment, the truck washes, stuff like that, I'm only speaking on Memphis. Now Little Rock, they got a drive through truck wash. You drive through it, boom. Does an okay job on it. They do. And everything over there, the fuel island, I ain't never had no problem with getting fuel. The fuel pump work. Here in Memphis, the fuel pump got a mind of its own. It works when it want to work. And that's very scarce. That's very rare that it works. But like I said, man, other than that, JB Hunt is a great starter company. It is a company that if you like the way things are going, it fits what you're looking for, it can be a foundation company for you. It can. Regional, the pay is, they do have per diem, but I think the pay starts at, I'm going to say it depends on your experience, really. You what was it? I think you can come in about 60 cent a mile or 58 to 60 cent a mile, and then they take out per diem and everything. So, you know, it's based on that. It is based on that and everything. But once again, it is a great company to start, get started with, get your feet wet, and grow with them. If, you know, if you like the way things are going, grow with them. Grow with them. I enjoy the home time that I'm getting. I enjoy the how concerned that they're showing with my family and what I went through with my sister-in-law and everything and my help. I thank him for that from the bottom of my heart. I thank JB Hunt from the bottom of my heart on that and everything. But other than that, y'all, she's sitting right there. I'm going to run in here and get these IFTA stickers right quick before they go to lunch. So stay tuned. I'll be right back. We're going to wrap some more all the way till I get the Indigo and do my fingerprinting and everything. I'll tell you how that went. I'm going to know if I can, while I'm doing this, I'm going to ask them. My Twic card expires December the 23rd of this year. I'm wondering if I can just do all that today. My Twic card and my hazmat fingerprint and everything. And then I just found out my concealed weapon license, it expires May the 1st. So it expires May the 1st. No, everything expiring on your boy Scoop. But stay tuned. I'll be right back. I'm gonna run some more with this and everything. But like I said, I'm here at the shop, at the yard right now, for to get these IFTA stickers. And I need to get some out of my truck and everything. I left some important papers in my truck. So I'm going to get them out. And then I'm going to get ready to head over there. It's 9 o'clock now. So let me get this. And your boy Scoop be right back. He just put the new IFTA on. I don't like to see when you got an IFTA here, IFTA here, IFTA here. If this is these 2 years, if these years are gone out, take it off and just put your one IFTA on there. That's it. Just put that one IFTA on there, man. Now, if you got the new IFTA in, say you got it in December. Okay, I can understand you running 22 and then sticking to 23. But hold the 23 in your permit book until that 22 go out. Peel it off, man. You got people got stickers all over the place, man. All you need is that one if the sticker on it and everything. Like I said, at the yard and on this side, I'm gonna show you a good example of what I mean. So I put them on, so we good. This one here, March 2022, so it goes out March of 23, so they'll put another one on there. But here's a good example of a truck. See, 2021, 2022. You don't need both of these on there. All you need is 2023. Take these off. When this one went out, they should have put this on. When this goes out, you put the 23. You don't need all them stickers on the truck, man. And believe me, we got some around here with 2020 on it and everything. You don't need all that, man. Just put that one on there, man, and be done. I was trying to see if I saw some with the three stickers on it and stuff, but I don't see it and everything. But like I said, other than that, it's all good. You know, you just have to make sure you take those stickers off the truck and everything, and make sure if they come with the permit for it, don't throw the permit away. Put the permit in your book and everything. They used to, when you peel the sticker off the little decal card, you had to put the decal card in your book and everything, because on the back of it was the information that registered those decals to that specific truck and everything. So you had to hold on to them and everything. But other than that, man, yeah, put the 23s on and take the rest of them off, all right? But this is your boy Scoob. Hold on 1 minute. Let me holler at these guys. All right, sorry about that. Y'all were hollering at the guys in the shop. Great guys, man. You know, those guys there, man. They want my truck. They want your boy Scoob truck, man. And everything. Telling me when I go out of town, leave the keys with them. They'll keep the miles on it and everything. But I don't think so. Here you have to pull up to the gate here and everything. And you have to sign out. If you even in your car, you have to sign out. Push the call button. The security will see you. Then you got the button up there where you enter in all your information and everything. Security will see you. And once they see you, which they know you, they get to know you, they'll buzz you through. I get a lot of compliments on the truck and stuff. So, but she dirty now, boy. She dirty on the outside. Been had a lot of rain here and everything. But like I said, other than that, man, it's tight to get in. You got a security, 24-hour security here, man. So you got to have a code to get the truck out. You got to have a code to get the trail out. You got to have a driver code. So it's they make it hard to get out of it, you know, and everything. So really, you have to make sure that they got you assigned to the truck and trailer before you even can get out the gate. So other than that, like I said, is they great on that and stuff. But had it been peaches and cream for your boy Scoob? Nope, it has not been peaches and cream for your boy Scoob. It's been hard. It's been some tough weeks. If I could put it on one page, my dislikes about JB Hunt, it would be that just the communication, man. That's it. Believe it or not, it'll just be the communication between the planners, the drivers, and the dispatch. The planner, the dispatcher, the driver. It's the communication there. I don't care what company you go to work for out here. If you don't have that communication, line of communication straight, where they communicating with everybody, it won't work. You're going to have all kind of problems, all kind of headaches and everything. And it'll get you, man. I found out something that was kind of disappointing and disturbing and everything from some drivers. I was like, but man, we were sitting around out there under the awning and talking, and they were saying they was running down to, this is regional now, said they was running down to Houston, picking up loads, coming back, St. Louis, Chicago, Charlotte, I'm like, what God doing? Your boy Scoob ain't been doing number 200 miles one way. You know, 200 miles one way as long as your boy Scoob been running it. But turn around and come back, that's 400. You know, it's 63 cent a mile. I ain't gonna lie to you about that. 63 cent a mile. Been doing 200 one way and everything. And picking up loads, going to pick up loads or going to deliver loads and everything. One trip, I think the longest trip I've had was since I've been here, the 9 months I've been here. I went to, the longest trip I ever ran over here was down to, was from Memphis to Lebanon, and then went from Lebanon, down to Mobile, Alabama. That's the longest run I've ever made over at J.B. Hunt. And I did it one time. One time. I did go from Memphis to Brookhaven. And then from, Pearl River, Louisiana. I went down there to Rooms to Go. Then left there and went over to New Orleans. And ended up shutting down in New Orleans. And then from New Orleans came back to Memphis. So those are my two longest trips since I've been here. do they have longer trips? Yeah, they have them. But certain drivers run them, I guess. I don't know. You know, all my years, man, you would think that stuff there would be over with. But, hey, it ain't. It still goes on. It still goes on. That's the trucking for you, man. That's trucking for you. It still goes on. So, hey, like I said, I'm not complaining. It's just that, hey, you expect more. In my years of driving, I expect more out of a mega carrier like this, like J.B. Hunt. J.B. Hunt, Schneider, Warner. I would expect more out of them because of their growth, their size, the equipment they have, the freight connections they have. I would expect more out of them than I would a smaller company and everything. But it is what it is, y'all. It is what it is. But other than that, man, there you have it. It is what it is. It is what it is for your boy Scoob. I just want to, you know, touch up on that and everything and come back and let you know everything's going okay. It's going good one day at a time. I'm a blessed man. Every day, I thank God for every day I'm able to open my eyes and see another day. I thank God for it. I thank God for my wife, my kids, my grandkids, my great-grandkids. I thank God for all of them. I thank God for my daughter-in-laws and my son-in-laws, you know. I just thank God for everybody, and not only them, my family, mother and father. You know, I know a lot of people don't have their mother or their father, but I thank God I still got my mother and father. I got my sisters and brothers, you know, and everything. I thank God for them and everything. But like I say, y'all, other than that, it's just a matter of taking one day at a time, acknowledging him in everything you do, respecting your fellow drivers, and don't be afraid to help your fellow drivers. If you see a driver that need help, don't be afraid to help them. Reach out and help them, man. Next thing I want to talk about is something serious. First off, let's keep a young man who went home to be with the Lord, not by his choice, but let's keep his mother, his father, his family in your prayers. Tyree Nelson Nichols, keep him in your prayers and everything. And a lot of people might get mad what I'm about to say next. Not only them, but the officers that done wrong. If they found guilty and done wrong, keep their family in your prayers and everything too. And everything. It's just a tragedy today here in Memphis. Once, like I said before, being a law enforcement officer takes a lot of patience, understanding, respect, and you just got to have it all. You got to have it all. Integrity. You got to have all that, man. Honesty. You got to have all that when you step up and put that uniform on and everything. You've got to have it all. But once again, let's keep them in our prayers and stuff. And we'll go from there. I don't want to say too much on that because I want to let it prevail. Everything that's done in the dark, you know, like I tell y'all, whatever, you can get away with it for so long. You can get away for doing wrong for so long. But when it catch up to you, oh, Lord, it's the precaution, the repercussion of it. Oh, man. Oh, Lord, it's unbearable. It's going to be unbearable. But like I said, let's keep them in your prayers and everything. Other than that, y'all, I don't want to speak too much on that topic right now. That'll be another topic that we'll talk about. Hold on, let me catch this right quick. What your boy Scoob looking at? Boy, if that ain't nice. That's pretty. That is nice. I like that. That's always been my dream truck right there. Not those mirrors on it, but that has always been my dream truck right there. The W900 Studio Sleeper. Just don't like these mirrors. Funny looking circle mirrors. I think that takes away from the truck. We here at Crow's. Boy, that is nice. Got the DEF on it. That's nice. Got new tread on it. Yeah, Crow Truck Sales. That's nice. They got a blue one over there, blue and white. But there you have it, that Studio Sleeper is what your boy always. This has been my dream truck since I started driving a truck. Always been my dream truck. Yeah, don't think about it. Like I said, them mirrors on the hood. I don't like them. I would have to switch them out. All right, there, YouTube. We done made it here. It's off of Mama Rye, right behind the Piccadilly's. Mama Rye and America Way. That's where the Indigo office is. It's right beside, where it's over in on the other side of the gate and everything. Behind Piccadilly is where it's at. So let me get my stuff together and get ready to go in here and do that and stuff. And your boy Scoob will be back once he come out. I'll let you know how everything went. Let's go get these fingerprints, man. And which is stupid to me, but might not be stupid to them, but it is what it is. So let's go get that done, and then I'll be back. All right. What's going on, YouTube? This your boy, man. We done made it out of there, man. We 8650, man. 8650. Do a fingerprint test just to take your fingerprints and stuff, man, for a background check. So I got 90 days now to go and take my take the written test on the computer. You don't have to do the 16 or 8-hour school course. You don't have to go do that if you already got a hazmat. But if you never had hazmat, or you had hazmat and you lost it, or you let it go and you're trying to get it back, you're gonna have to take the computer test at the DMV. But before you take the test at the DMV, you got to go get fingerprint. Then you got to go and do a 16-hour course on hazmat in some trucking school or something. And then I think it's a trucking school, or you can do it online, something maybe she was saying. But by you already having a hazmat, all you got to do is go to the DMV and take the 30-question test. You pass it, boom. You keep your hazmat. And when the background comes back from Homeland Security, if everything's good, boom. You go back and take the letter that you get from Homeland Security, go back to the DMV, take your photo, get your new driver's license. You're good for another 5 years on your hazmat and 8 years on your driver's license. Like I said, my concealed expires on May the 1st anniversary, which would be the anniversary of J.B. Hunt. It expires May the 1st. My trick card expires December the 23rd of this year. So everything expires this year and stuff. So I got to, I've got to get all that taken care of and stuff. So I'm going to keep my hazmat, even though none of these companies, I ain't seen a company yet that pays you real good to have a hazmat and go through what you have to go through. I ain't found a company yet that does that, but it is what it is. But like I said, we have made it out here, and we've done that. So now I think I'm going to wait till next Friday and go take a shot at the test, and I'll take you with me on that next Friday and stuff. But what y'all think of that there, W9? Boy, that's, man, that is pretty, boy. That was Scoob's dream truck when he was getting into this back in 88, when I thought about started driving charter buses in 88. And in 90, I got into the big trucks, driving trucks. So, man, I loved that truck, man. Loved it. I don't know. I might see what kind of numbers we can run. I got the guy running some numbers for me, so I'm going to see what he come up with. If it come up with some good numbers, good figures, then your boy Scoob will let you in on it. But other than that, man, finna get ready to pick mom up from work and stuff and everything and stuff. But it's all good, man. It's all good. Oh, and before anybody say anything, that is gray hair in my nose. My nose, for some reason, is like my granddaddy. I don't know why, but I have a lot of gray hairs in my nose. That is not no green men in my nose, okay? Before y'all say it, I saw it. I told you, I go back and look at each video clip before I upload these videos. So there you have it. That's this gray. My nose is filled with gray hairs, man. I don't know why. My granddaddy was like that and everything. Must be something I inherited from my granddaddy, but hey, it is what it is. But other than that, y'all, they're going to release the video from the body cam tonight at 6 o'clock and everything. Something I don't want to watch. I really don't. You know, I like trucking. We got truck drivers out here that don't need to be truck drivers, and we got some law enforcement brothers out here that don't need to be in law enforcement. So I'm on both sides of the fence with it, okay? I'm on both sides. I'm going to respect both sides. But when you're wrong, you're wrong. Like I said before, what's done in the dark, it's going to come to light, just like the truck drivers out here, what y'all out here doing in the dark. You know, like I got some partners of mine out here, man, driving these trucks, keep unplugging their computer and running, trying to get that money in. Hey, they making money doing it, but like I told them, I said, listen, man, what's done in the dark gonna come to light, dog. It's gonna hurt you. It's gonna cost you more. The more you get away with it, my grandmother always used to say, the more you think you're getting away with it, the worse it's going to be when they find out on you. So if you got the skin to tough it out, let it be what it is. But you think you're getting away with it, but remember one thing, God sees it all. God sees it all, man. So you might be getting over on me and somebody else, but God sees it all. Just like I called back to JB about that bonus money that they was giving. The terminal manager said that it was for January. He put a memo out saying if you was here starting January the 1st of 2022 up until January of 2023, you would get it. But he didn't say that you had to be working there. He just said if you're working from January the 1st of 2022 you would, if you started January 1st, 2022, you would get the bonus, but it's not true. You've got to be there for a year to get it. So from January the 1st of 2022 to January the 1st of 2023, then you get it. If you came after January the 1st, you don't get it. Ain't that a trip? That's a trip, ain't it? There you go. They got ways of keeping that money, boy. So they got ways of keeping that money. I figure it don't matter if you started February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. As long as you was here in 22, boom, you should get it. But you don't. It is what it is, man. It is what it is. But it's in the good Lord's hand, you know. But like my wife always used to say, never count the money that ain't in your hand. And that is some true words. Never count the money if it ain't in your hands. In that case, if it ain't in your account, don't count that money, okay? But like I said, other than that, man, my biggest peas over here at JB Hunt is the containers, man, them chassis. There's too many chassis to be not repaired. And you got trucks riding around and that's all they do is repair the chassis. And them chassis sitting at the rail with a red tag on them. And the communication between the planners, the dispatch, to the driver, they need work bad. Because like I said, it's only 9 words. Let's see. Pre-plan, cancel, stand by for next pre-plan. 6 words. Yeah, next pre-plan. I can't count pre-plan twice. Pre-plan, okay? That's it, 6 words. That's all they got to type to you. Load cancel, stand by for next load. 6 words. I don't know where I came up with 9. Oh, I guess because I was counting pre-plan. Okay, pre-plan, that's it. That's it. But that's all they got to do. Take that and type 6 words, and that's it. That's what you call communicating with the driver. Like I said, I drop a load, get ready to head back to get my next load. I don't know the load. They didn't took the load off of me until I called to see, man, what was the trailer number, the pickup and the load number? It ain't on the screen. Oh, man, they took that load off of you. Stand by for another load. Why in the hell you, what? But that's what they do over here. And to me, it pisses me off because, when I get a load, I go straight to the customer. I've been doing that for years, man. I tell you, I told you in some videos, when you get pick up at your shipper, take it on into the customer. If you can go there and go to bid, go to bid. Boom. Stop before you get ready to get into the customer at the last truck stop, a good truck stop you're going to get to. Go there, take your shower, get you something to eat. Boom. Go on to the customer. If you can park there, park there. If you feel comfortable sleeping there, sleep there. If you don't, go back to the nearest safe place, but show yourself arriving there. PC to a safe haven. You can PC back to the shipper, the receiver. Remember, you can PC to the receiver. If you go straight to the receiver, you can PC from the receiver to a safe haven, and then you can PC back, okay? Well, mama finna get ready and get in. Let me get off this thing, man. I have to give her my undivided attention when she get in the truck because she get to looking at me like I'm crazy. But y'all, I'm going to bring this to an end. Y'all be careful. Be safe. Keep the good Lord with you in everything you do and say. And continue to keep Scooby doing my wife in your prayers. We'll do the same for each and every one of you all. We love you. We thank God for you. Act like she bolding back there or something, man. Throwing stuff in my truck. I don't know what's wrong with her. But y'all continue to keep the good Lord with you in everything you do and say. And everything. And keep Scooby doing my wife in your prayers. We'll do the same for each and every one of you all. We love you. We thank God for you. This is boy Scooby Doo. She don't want to get in the truck, so I'm going to have to end it right here. Y'all be careful, man. I love you, man. Pray for the city of Memphis. Pray for the city of Memphis. Pray for Tyree Nichols' family. Keep them in your prayers. Keep the city of Memphis in your prayer. Because you know what? Your boy Scooby-Doo ain't worried about it. Because like Karen Hawthorne said, won't he do it? Yes, he will. This is your boy Scooby-Doo.